모든 게 궁금해 할 때
Hello everyone, it is Esther here and welcome back to my channel. So, I haven't made a video in a while. I was going to do a review of Us, but I sort of just procrastinated it and I never really got to it. So by the time, you know, it was time to post another video, it had been quite a few weeks since I watched the film, so I just didn't think it was worth it because no one would really be that interested anymore. So instead, I'm just gonna stick to my usual... Well, there isn't really a usual on this channel, but my preferred form of video, which is the sort of very brief, very simple video essay. And today's topic is young adult slash teenage films and why they're so crap, because I don't know about you, but I am tired of seeing the same thing over and over again. Like, yeah, sometimes I will be interested in a film if it has a decent premise, like To All the Boys I've Loved Before, which was an absolutely amazing film, or something which has a positive message, such as Dumplin', which I don't think that many people have seen. But yeah, I'm going to just get into why I cannot stand most films sort of targeted towards teenagers. So, if you haven't noticed yet, teenage slash young adult movies suck ass. Cringy acting, awful dialogue, and completely unrealistic plots seem to be popping up everywhere in teenage targeted media. From The Duff to You Get Me, and Friend Request to The Kissing Booth. If you're a teenager in 2019 and you just want to enjoy a movie that you can relate to, 9 times out of 10, you will not find a thing. For example, let's take The Duff, a film that I could barely watch 20 minutes of before I tried to gouge my eyes out. The whole concept of the film is a girl feeling alienated from her friends, who are much conventionally prettier than her and more popular, which then leads to her getting a makeover by some boy she's barely friends with. Now, I have a problem with this film for many reasons. However, in the 20 minutes that I watched it for, one main thing came up. The whole concept pushes the idea that all groups of friends have this one friend, the Duff, aka designated ugly fat friend, that is way less pretty, thin, etc. than the rest of the friends in the group, that they only keep around to make themselves look better. This is complete bullshit. At my school, people may still be shallow, but not so fucking shallow that they would pretend to be friends with someone just to boost their own ego. In the sort of popular groups at my school, everyone is different. There are girls who are both attractive in the eyes of society and ones who are not, by beauty standards, but they're all still friends because they want to be friends with each other. Oh lord, I have never heard of that before. But the point is that nobody, at least hardly anyone, is so cruel that they surround themselves with people they don't even like for their own self-benefit. Another weird trend that I've noticed in films aimed at teenagers is romance, in quotes, movies that glorify abuse. In fact, it's not even recent, as this theme was prevalent in Twilight too. These films seem to be pushing this agenda that if a boy is not stalking you, fighting over you, fighting with you, or invading your privacy, then he isn't worth it. For example, people were losing their fucking minds over The Kissing Booth last year. I watched it, and it was a train wreck. This poor girl gets sexually harassed and then apologizes to the guy, even agreeing to have a date with him. Her main love interest, Noah, is even fucking worse. First, he's a sexist prick. He constantly calls her bossy for literally just expressing her opinion or telling him common sense things like, hey, please stop being a violent piece of shit all the time. And at the beginning of the movie, after she gets harassed by almost every boy in her school for wearing a skirt that's really short, Noah tells her that she's asking for it. He apologizes afterwards, but he still should not have said it in the first place. This is supposed to be our main love interest? What the hell? He's also controlling, violent, not towards her, but still violent, and just an annoying little shit in general. But this girl just about throws away everything to be with him. These kinds of messages should not be shown to young, impressionable girls, and boys too, as it tells them they're allowed to treat women like trash and they will still want to date them. Now, into the actual question of why are these movies so bad? It's a pretty easy question to answer that will take you like 2 seconds of research. They are all being made by people who were teenagers decades ago. For example, the guy who directed The Duff is 44 years old, not to mention he's a guy, which doesn't really help when you're trying to direct a film about a teenage girl's experience. Another example of people making films that they know nothing about is F the Prom, which was made by the Fine Brothers, two guys who were homeschooled and never went to an American high school in their life. Now, one final problem that I have with teenage movies is the rise of Wattpad stories, written by horny teenage girls who probably hate their own lives so much that they create this world where all is perfect, at least in their eyes, and ridiculous events occur that would never actually happen in real life. The thing is, these girls grew up reading books and stories and watching films such as Twilight, which portray abusive relationships in, you know, a romantic manner. So then they go on to write Wattpad books, which then get turned into more movies about abusive relationships that are portrayed as love. It's just an endless cycle of pain. It's not all bleak news, however, thank God, as there are more young directors making movies for teenagers recently, such as Quinn Shepherd, a 23-year-old woman who wrote the script for Blame when she was 15 and directed and starred in it herself. It's not a perfect film by any means, but the atmosphere, brilliant acting and soundtrack make it too good to be categorised with such crap as The Kissing Booth. Now, this video is mainly made out of frustration for the garbage films I came across on Netflix. However, I also believe that I can at least give a shred of advice among all this pessimism. There will be a film coming out this year called After. It was based on a Wattpad story. Am I surprised? And although I haven't read it, I have heard that it is incredibly problematic. Like many other Wattpad books, it glorifies abusive relationships. In fact, people are so pissed off about it that a fucking petition was made against it. They got over 27,000 signatures. Now that's a sign that something is seriously wrong. So, my advice is, don't watch it. Encourage everyone you know who might be interested not to watch it. If you have kids, tell them not to watch it. Spread it everywhere. Just boycott this film, because we do not want to give the greedy bastards making this any money. Because what they're trying to do is squeeze money out of naive teenage girls without giving a second thought about the kind of damage they could be inflicting on them. As I said before, it's a cycle. If teenagers grow up watching movies with these awful messages, they will carry on thinking that this is what life should be like, and then they'll write their own books or make their own films about the same crap, and it will just never end. So, calming down now, do not watch After, do not support it at all, and try and make a difference. If you're interested in creating your own media, whether it be writing or directing or anything like that, please research and please make sure you avoid these things, because we cannot have teenagers be subjected to such things. I know I sound like someone's mum right now, but honestly, it is a serious issue and it's been pissing me off for way too long. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. If you agree with me, please tell me in the comments, because holy shit, I know I'm not the only one who thinks like this, because there are so many other people who are tired with these sort of films coming out. If you are interested in YouTubers who talk about specifically teenage films, you should definitely check out Julia Cudney, as she often discusses what's wrong and what's right with teenage movies these days. So if you're interested, you have to check out her channel. She is super popular, she's got 100,000 subscribers, but she honestly deserves so much more because she puts in so much effort into her videos. So yeah, I hope you guys enjoyed this. I will see you later. Follow my Twitter in the description. Subscribe, like the video, comment, whatever you want. That would be super helpful to me, because I'm the struggling channel. Okay. I might see you next week. I might not. Goodbye.